So hi, my name is Esias Bedingar, and I studied here at UK. I studied, I was majoring in public health, minoring in neuroscience, and now I'm at Harvard studying, getting a master's of science in global health and population. I've been at Harvard for the past 8-9 months, and it's hard in terms of classes and life, because everything is around like my classes and all that. But I've also been doing research, and it's a research master. I'm very interested in malaria. At Harvard, I'm really trying to get all the opportunities I can to understand all the factors affecting malaria. So I'm currently involved in research in a lab at Harvard, but also doing global health research on malaria. So talking about the global health research, I'm really trying to work with governments and also non-governmental organizations in order to understand issues like insecticide treated nets coverage, or like why do the rates of malaria are high in one region and not high in another region. So those are the very specific questions that I'm interested in while they're at Harvard. But I'm also interested in looking at how can we stop and control malaria biologically. So really looking at, I would say, directly at the source, the mosquito. So I'm really trying to merge my two interests, which are medicine and also global health, to be able to understand the complex issues of malaria. Before doing any type of research, you really need to read a lot of literature, right? And so at Harvard, I know how to analyze direct, and I don't have to go and learn again how to do it. And I think that's one thing that was very important that I learned from my time here at the College of Public Health. And coming from the College of, you know, of art and science, mostly for the Department of Neuroscience, and combining the two really gave me an idea to push my research further, and wanting to combine my two interests together and wanting to do for the future maybe a research on cerebral malaria. So a way to combine my interest in infectious disease, which is mostly come from public health, but all in global health, and neuroscience, which is cerebral malaria. And so that's kind of the reasons for why I studied both together and what I want to do in the future. Participating in the global health case competition really helped me understand, or really gave me the tools to understand how to analyze case studies, mostly global health case studies that we, I would say, do every time at Harvard, especially in my master's, like the Global Health and Population master's. So I think that was really helpful to, especially for me and my studies, yeah. My fondest memories, you know, will always be studying at the library, to be honest, because there it's, I don't know, I haven't found a place to study yet. You know, I haven't found, I'm trying everything. There's so many night libraries that, I don't know, it's not like UK where the library, core 1, 2, a 5th floor was like the best place to be, you know? I don't know. I really miss that one thing from UK, because I haven't found that at Harvard yet, so we'll see. Thinking about when I was at UK, I used to say that I was doing everything, that everyone was saying like I was doing everything, but to be honest, now at Harvard, I feel like everyone is the same and everyone was doing everything. And so I feel like this is an important factor that really helped me actually understand everything that is going on really at Harvard. Because we really, to be successful, I think, we really need, it's not be good at one thing. You really have to be able to understand what others are doing, and be able also to communicate your specialization to other people. So I think that's something that is very important in our society today, because we really need to collaborate and work in teams. And so that that experience here at UK, working with different organizations, but also doing different research experiences and all that, really equipped me to be, I would say, successful at Harvard. Yeah. So I'm planning to continue with medical school right after my master's, because that's ultimately the goal, to try to find a cure or try to help people who are suffering from cerebral malaria. So I think really combining those two interests together, through, like here at UK, but also at Harvard, would help me during my time in medical school. So without all those scholarships, I don't think I would have been able to conduct all the research I conducted, or even been able to go and present my research to those different conferences I've been to, or even been able to travel to different, you know, conferences, or to, you know, just learn more about, you know, neuroscience, or learn more about global health in general. So I think scholarships are really crucial today, because it's a financial help that really helps you, I would say, achieve your goal in a way. Mostly for international students, it's really hard to get a scholarship in the US in general. It's really hard for international students to get a scholarship. And so the small scholarships can really help international students go and present their studies, their research projects. And basically, personally, it really helped me go and present the research. And I feel like this is what really helped me get into Harvard today, because it's really a research institution. And without all my research projects and all my presentations, Harvard wouldn't have considered my work as valid, if I wasn't able to, for example, go to a place, a very big conference, and present my work there. So I think getting those scholarships really put a weight on your work, and that's the reason why it's really important to support those students so that they can achieve great things later in their life. If it's like they're going to professional schools or even graduate schools. So this year, the International Center has an international fund that you can give to. It doesn't matter how big or small you give, but just give.